Samvedanakhe Uttitha Vachakatvena Prayuktaha. In the second case, Uttitha means Vachakatvena Prayuktaha, as the one which is named as the one which reveals Brahma. So therefore, Yatra Uttitha Veda Shabdaha. So that means Brahma is that, two ways. The Brahma is the one which is the cause of Vedas. Brahma is the one which is unfolded by Vedas. The two meanings are there. Okay. And then, okay, that is fine. Maybe the Vedas unfold what Brahma is, but what exactly is its nature? So, Tatha Aya, that is Ayam. That is Tatha Ayam. That means, so is this, means Tatha Veda Shabda Pratipadya Samvid Rupaha Ayam Paramatma. There you have to add that Ayam means this Paramatma is of what nature? You have to make Adhyara there. Samvid Rupaha. Why? Afterwards it is being told, Tanmayatvena Vibhati is being told. Therefore, Tatha Ayam. So this Paramatma is as unfolded by Vedas. What is its nature? Samvid Rupaha. Samvid Rupaha is Chaitanya Swarupaha. The one whose nature is nothing but pure consciousness, pure awareness alone, Chaitanya and Chaitanya alone, what is called as Chit. So therefore, that is what is this Paramatma. So therefore, now the question arises, if this Paramatma is, as told in the first line, not an object of vak and the mind, how are we going to know it? Because for us, anything can be known through the instrumentation of words and mind. And words and mind means sense organs do come there. So because word, that is, where the perception is possible, the words are able to convey us. So therefore, if it is yadi vacham agocharaha paramatma, if paramatma is not an object of words and also the mind, how, that is, how is it known that it is the nature of samved? So that is being told now, answer is given. Saha tanmayatvena vibhati. Saha paramatma tanmayatvena, tanmayatvena, jyotirmayatvena, or samvidmayat, samvidmayatvena. So it is revealed how? As the very Chaitanya Tattva. Why? What sadhanas do you need to know Chaitanya? I hope you know what is Chaitanya. What is Chaitanya? In us, what is Chaitanya? Are we Chaitanya? What is the distinction between Sachetana and Chaitanya? Sentient and sentiency. What is the distinction between these two? Simple, Sachetana means that is with Chaitanya. This Chaitanyena saha vartate iti. Okay? But Chaitanya is verily Chaitanya. So, as we obtain today, are we Chaitanya or Sachetana? Or Achetana? anyone who will say Achetana? The question is, how do you know that you are Achetana? I know, I am Achetana. That may be true, you may be Achetana too much here. You may be dull, that is okay, we won't deny that. So, but at least how do you know that you are Achetana? That because of which you know that you are Achetana inert is the Chaitanya Tattva, because of which you are called as Sachetana. You are called Sachetana because as you obtain now as an individual, there is some Achetana aspect also. Is there is a mix-up of Sachetana, not Sachetana, Chaitanya and Achetana, Jada. Therefore you are called as Sachetana. But what we do is, we take that achetana, jada aspect, anatma aspect as I, and we don't know that chaitanya is our swarupa, therefore all samsara stuck. So, how far you have to go now to discover atma? You have already agreed that you are sachetana, you have already agreed, otherwise you have to revert back there only. So, and why you are sachetana? Because jada aspect is there and chaitanya is there. Now you are mistaking the jada aspect, the body, that means the gross body, stula sharira, sukshi sharira, karana sharira, all these are jada or chaitanya. Why are they jada? Because they are known, drishyaha. So therefore, drip tattva, chaitanya tattva is my swarupa, but these anatma are mistaken as atma. So therefore, this has to be now separated. Separated in terms of viveka. In terms of discrimination, viveka, we have to separate and discover our swarupa. Now, that chaitanya aspect, you see, doesn't depend on anything for knowing. That's why I say it is saprakasha, because you may say in the waking state, I am there. Presently, I am there in the waking state. I can say, I am there. How? How do you say you are there now? With the eyes we are able to see the body. Okay, yes, that's right. Okay. And we are able to feel it. We are able to hear also. We are able to smell also. Bath not taken much more. So that so we are able to taste also. Okay. In the dream, how are you doing that you are there? Because you are external. Jnanendriyas are not available. Okay. Still you know, I was dreaming, you know that. Okay. With antakarana was there. In sleep, were you there?
Yes.
How did you know? See?
Huh?
Yes, recalling, that is true. So that means your sense organs which you are using in the waking were absent. Antakarana which you had used in the dream was absent. What made you know that you were there, which you are recollecting afterward? I slept, I did not know. It is who? It is me who had slept and who had now woken up. Means the one who had slept and one who is woken up and answering the question, did you sleep, etc. Yes, I was there, etc. So, on what, because of what did you know that? Antakarana was not there, senses were not there. Means it is something which is self-evident, swaprakasha. Chaitanya is swaprakasha, it is self-evident. So therefore it says, tanmayatvena saha paramatma. So though not object of Vedas and the mind, though not object of the words and the mind, saha tanmayatvena. Tanmayatvena means jyotiswarupena, swayam jyotihi. Brahmana Kapoor used the word there, swayam jyoti, swaprakasha, swayam jyoti means self-evident, which itself is a knowledge principle. Actually, because of that knowledge principle, you are able to know through the jnanendriyas and the mind intellect, which are otherwise inert in nature. So just as water cannot illumine, but if sun gets reflected in the water, that water is able to illumine because of the reflected light. So also, jnanendriyas and the mana buddhi of their own are not capable of knowing because they are inert in nature. But the presence of this chaitanya makes them know. So therefore, itself is a knowledge principle, doesn't need any other means to know it. And then why should it take to Vedanta? It's only to destroy ignorance. We are ignorant of our swarupa. That ignorance is destroyed by Vedantic unfoldment, the teaching. So afterward, one's own swarupa shines of its own, being swayam jyoti, being the very, that is, swaprakasha tattva, tanmayatvena vibhati. So it shines. So, rajan. So Bhashyakara adds that, एवं एव अस्मद् अनुभवः न अत्र अविश्वासः कर्तव्यः इत्यर्थः राजन् इति सो दिस इज बिकॉज़ Dhritarashtra may say, I think, how is it possible and all that? He says, Vashyakara says, evam eva asmadurvava. This is our experience, direct experience. So, you can't contradict. Na atra avishvasaha kartavyaha. So therefore, one should need, you should not have distrust in that. So, all that Sanat Kumara can do is only appeal to the Shraddha of Dhritarashtra. He can't impose on him. So, how can he impose? So, if suppose, no, it is wrong, what can you do? What's been done to you? Go ahead. So, therefore, it is not possible. So, therefore, he says, please don't doubt this statement. This is what is the, which has been personally verified by us all. Or it can be, athava, shruti, smriti, itihasa, purana, adishu, jyotirmayatvena pratiyate. Or the tanmayatvena vibhati, vibhati, that is vibhati, he has said, that is vibhati means visheshena bhati, in its own swarupa, is discovered by us. So therefore, please do not entertain any doubt. Or that vibhati can be, so it is declared in the shruti, smriti, itihasa, purana. Shruti, smriti, itihasa, purana. Please don't entertain any doubt, because why it is so? Shruti speaks, Shruti has no reason why it should tell the lie. Who has given Shruti?
Ishwara.
Ishwara, what purpose has he got to tell the lie? And why Vedas are given? Vedas are given for the benefit of humanity. So, for the out of kindness they are given. And what Ishwara is to get from these Vedas? PhD? What is he going to get? Ishwara has nothing to get out of it. So if he has nothing to get out of it, why should he tell a lie as such? Why Ishwara? Even this Mahasaya, that means these great saints like this, for example. So Shruti is Smriti. The Smritis are given by great master. Itihasa, for example, Mahabharata. Who has written Mahabharata? Vyasa. Ramayana, Valmiki. So Purana, who? Vyasa. We should know, that means, what type of persons these were. How highly integrated people these were. And not only that, they had nothing to get from this world. As Ishwara, even this Valmiki, because Valmiki didn't write the Ramayana when he was a dacoit. So after gaining knowledge, he had nothing to gain from this world. And yet, because of command of Brahmaji, he did write that for the benefit of the humanity. That is the case. Vyasa, what he had to get from this world? Nothing. And why should you lie? You know, Vyasa had told once, even out of joke, I have not told a lie. I have told this incident. See, once Vyasa happened to go to Gandhari. And he had come walking from a very long distance, he was tired. Gandhari, so as a hostess, she extended all hospitality and this bath, gave him food, etc. And he was asked to take rest. And after taking rest, Vyasa was about to go. At that time he asked Gandhari, mother, can I help you or can I do something for you? If you want anything, please let me know. I have got the capacity to fulfill your desire. Gandhari said, I would like to have 100 sons. Tathastu, and he went. Afterwards she conceived. Kunti also conceived afterwards. After 9 months, Kunti delivered Dharmaraja. 10 months passed, 11 months passed, 12 months passed. Gandhari didn't deliver anything. She got frustrated. She was frustrated. And much more frustrated because Kunti got a son. So therefore more frustration. And out of frustration, without knowledge of Dhritarashtra, she pounded the stomach. Some lump of flesh came out. I don't know how it coincided or otherwise. Exactly at that time Vyasa had come there. Whether he came to know, therefore he came, or whatever it may be. So he came to know. He came there. When he came, Gandhari said, Maharaj, What did you say? I will get 100 sons. Yes. Why? What happened? This is what has happened. Achcha. At that time he said, listen, I have not told a lie even out of humor or a joke, because out of joke if you tell a lie, Chitragupta doesn't punch the car, you know. You know what is that? Papa is not counted. Just for a joke, just to pull someone's leg, it is not. But even for that, I have not told a lie. My words cannot go wrong. Then he asked, where is that? What is that? So he said, then he tells that, do like this, this, etc. And afterward, one more also, 101. Dushala also is there. So like that, okay. But this is what Vyasa is. This is the stature of Vyasa. So the one who has not told even a single lie out of joke, so how can he bluff in these Puranas, Mahabharata, Brahma Sutras and all these? How is it possible? It's just not possible. Therefore one should have Shraddha. So therefore Shruti, Smriti, Itihasa, Purana. All these unfold Brahma as Jyotirmaya. So therefore Vibhati. So it is very clear. Okay. Now, Dhritarashtra wants to know the nature of Vedas. So he asks a question. He says, a person who studies Vedas at the same time indulges in all adharmic acts, does he get papa or not? Very interesting question. And more relevant to Dhritarashtra. Because today also the same thing. Everyone does puja, etc., and others act cutting the throat, everything goes on there, isn't it? So out externally puja, prayer, japa, everything goes on, but internally all nonsense goes on. So like that, Vedas have, Dhritarashtra is asking the question. Dhritarashtra vacha, rucho yajusha dhiteyaha, Sama Vedam Chayo Dvijaha Papani Kurvan Papina Lipyate Nasa Lipyate Racho Yajusha Dhiteyaha Sama Vedam Chayo Dvijaha Papani kurvan papena lipyate na sa lipyate yaha dvijaha papani kurvan ruchaha yajushi adhite ruchaha yajushi adhite yaha cha Samavedam adhiti. Yahacha Samavedam adhiti. Yahacha Papani Kurvan Samavedam cha adhiti. Okay, that Papani Kurvan has to be taken along with that also. Yahacha cha stands for Papani Kurvan. So, Samavedam adhiti. Saha Papena lipyate na lipyate adva. Na lipyate va. Saha Papena lipyate. Na lipyate adva. A given person, yaha, whoever may be the person, yaha, dvijaha, dvijaha brahmana or vaisya kshatriya, brahmana vaisya kshatriya, brahmana kshatriya vaisya. So yaha, dvijaha, what does he do? Say, papani kurvan means committing sins. Having taken to Papa Acharana. What is Papa Acharana? Nishiddha Acharana. So, Nishiddha Acharana. And what is Nishiddha? Forbidden. By who? Shastra. What is the Shastra? Vedas. Look here. You have to come to it. Vedas says, Vihita, do this and don't do this. Now this person, you see, he does what is forbidden by the Shastra. At the same time, what does he do? Studies the Vedas, chant. Studies there means chanting only. Swadhyaya. Swadhyaya means here chanting, reciting the Vedas. So, adhite, swadhite, that person, that way, yes. Ruchaha adhite, that is, means chants, Rigveda. Yajushi adhite, Yajurveda he studies, he means he chants. Samavedam cha adhite, he learns Samaveda, all papani kurvan, doing the karma, the papa. The question is now, saha satya person, papena by papa, lipyate, is he? That is, the papen lipyate means like this. Does he incur sin? That way. So, does he incur sin? Nasa lipyate va, or does he not incur sin? Why? He is learning Vedas. That is the question. Answer is, Sanat Sujata Uvacha Nainam Samandricho Vapi Yajoshicha Vichakshana Rayante Karmana Papa Nate Mithya Bravimyaham. Vichakshana enam samani ruchaha vapi yajushicha yajushicha karmanaha na trayanti karmanaha na trayanti. Vichakshana enam samani ruchaha vapi yajushicha papat karmanaha, or karmanaha papat, you can say. Karmanaha papat, karmanaha papat, na trayante. Papat karmanaha, or karmanaha papat, na trayante. Te aham mithya na bravimi. Te aham mithya na bravimi. By the by, I overlooked to tell one thing. That book, Varanasi book, with Shankara Bhasha, Nilakanti Tika and Hindi translation. There are many mistakes in that. Even that word translation is given is not very correct at many places, which I discovered later. But there was no alternative because no other books were available. Translation Mission publication with English translation is out of print itself. So that is that. And also Bhasha has seen at many places. That is, entire bhasha is not there. Just beginning of quotation is given there. And otherwise there are these old books are there, but they are not available now. So that is what it is. So totally don't rely on that. I prefer because Nilakandi Tika, something additional will be there, but there is nothing much in that, but this even also mistakes are found. Even that translation is not at all reliable at all places. Of course, many places can help us, but not totally reliable. Vichakshana. Vichakshana means, O intelligent one. Enam. Enam means this person. Who is that person? Who learns, who recites Vedas, but not simply recite Vedas. How? Papani kurvan. Doing papas means committing sins, who recites Vedas. Means, enam means papani kurvan rigvedadin adhiti. This person who studies or who learns Vedas committing sin, so enam, samani means samaveda, ruchaha, rigveda, va api or also yajushi, yajurveda, karmanaha, papat, na trayanti, cannot save him from karmanaha, papat, the sins incurred by his own deeds, by his own karmas, cannot protect him at all. They cannot save him. Now, Dhritarashtra must have doubted, how is it possible? Vedas are so great, how can they not protect him from the sin? Are they so important? Is they therefore, or Dhritarashtra, generally, maybe from facial expression he must have found, or just to make him understand that I am not telling a lie, that means trust these words, he says, Te means to you, O Dhritarashtra, aham mithya na bravimi. I am not lying, I am not telling a lie to you, this is the fact. So, That means the Vedas cannot protect or save the person who studies, learns them side by side committing the sins. They cannot protect him. So what do they do? This is what the Vedas do with respect to this person. Na chandasi vrijinatarayanti mayavinam mayaya vartamanam nidam shakunta iva jata pakshaha chandasenam prajahantyantakale. What is that? Acha, ulta is that. Okay. I take this. Ah, that's okay. I take this anvaya. When you take anvaya, no problem. Siddha ho jayega wo. Jata pakshaha shakuntaha needam iva. Jata pakshaha shakuntaha needa pakshaha. Even the reading is differing? The lines okay. Jata pakshaha shakuntaha needam iva. Even that printing is also horrible. In fact, I got Xerox and enlarged, and even then I gave up. I said nothing doing it. Even then it didn't serve. In fact, that very small this thing, same book I had got enlarged as such. After also it, I found it too much, you know, it's not very clumsy thing. I gave it. I had one book, fortunately, old book, the bit helped. Jata pakshaha shakuntaha needam iva enam chandansi enam chandansi antakale prajahanti enam chandansi antakale prajahanti mayavinam chandansi mayavinam chandansi vrijanat na tarayanti mayavinam chandansi vrijanat na tarayanti. Take this way. Mayavinam maya vartamanam mayavinam maya vartamanam chandansi vrijanat na tarayanti. Actually, no, this is the right way. No, you take the means. First line should be na chandansi, then needam shakunta second, and take the anvaya of first line first. Mayavinam maya vartamanam chandansi vrijanat na tarayanti. Then illustration. Jatapakshaha shakuntaha needam iva enam chandansi antakale prajahanti. That is the right way of taking it. Okay. First, mayavinam. This mayavi, who is that mayavi? Not Ishwara. Mayavi is hypocrite. This hypocrite means papachari, dharma dhvaji. This person shows that he is a great Vaidika by reciting the Vedas. And actually what does he do? He goes against the Vedas, means whatever that Vedas has asked not to do, he does. Has he got Shraddha in the Vedas? That means he's a hypocrite. Dharmadvaji. That means, then why does he take to Vedas, learning of Vedas? Some other gain, to show other people that he is a great Vaidika, etc. And not really abide by what is told in the Vedas. So therefore, mayavinam, this hypocritical person. So with means, yes. And therefore, mayaya vartamanam means mithyacharinam, whose conduct is totally, that is, against the Vedic injunction. Maya vartamanam is hypocrite. So mayavinam here, mayavinam has to be taken as dharmadvaji. Dharmadvaji means the person who takes to the learning of Vedas only to show that he is a great Vaidika, but not really means this papachari, the first mayavinam is papacharinam or nastikam. Maya vartamanam means mithyacharinam. So one whose conduct is which is hypocritical. So vartamanam. Chandansi. Chandansi means Vedas. So Vedas. Vrujinat na tarayanti. Vrujinat na tarayanti. So why this Chandansi called, Vedas are called Chandas, Chandansi? See, like this. Like the leaves. Leaves, see, a tree which is full of leaves is get covered by the leaves. So also, the Karmakanda portion of Vedas, they cover who? The very Brahma. Means you are not able to appreciate because a person carried away by the phalas that are told in the Karmakanda, and Karmakanda does deals with sadhya, sadhana, field. What is that? Samsara only. So those who are carried away by that are not able to know what the Brahma is, like it covers as it were. Okay. So mayavinam chandasi means Vrijinat na tarayanti. That is, Vrijinat means papa, from the papa, the sin. They don't uplift him, they don't save him, they don't protect him. How? An illustration is given. Jata pakshaha shakuntaha. Shakunta is birds. So birds, you see, just after hatching, the wings are not developed. It takes some time for them to develop the wings. And till the wings are developed, where these birds are there in the nest only. Jata pakshaha, the moment the wings are born, what do the shakuntaha birds do? Needam iva, means needam prajahanti iva. Just as they abandon the nest the moment the wings are born, like that. Needam prajahanti iva, that prajahanti has to be brought there. Just as the birds after getting, that means developing the wings, that means they abandon the nest, so iva like that. Enam. Enam means this mithyacharinam, maya vartamanam, this hypocritical person. Antakali, at the time of death, chandasi prajahanti, prajahanti. Chandasi, Vedas, what they do? They abandon means they don't save him at all. The punya is not going to work him at all. More or less, this nowadays religion is going in terms of this only. Puja, this, that, every, not only Hindu only, other religion also. Really it cannot, some punya may be there, but really it cannot save. Okay. Now, Dhritarashtra started wondering, how is it possible? If that is the case, why these people are wasting the time, whole lifelong they are chanting the Vedas? This place, is it not a mere prattling on this part, etc.? So he asked counter question. Dhritarashtra uvacha, na ced veda veda vidam, shatratum shakta vichakshana, atha kasmat pralapoyam, brahmananam sanatanaha. Vichakshana, earlier Sanat Kumara said, they called him Vichakshana, now he is addressing him as Vichakshana. Okay, Vichakshana, of course. I think Sanat Kumara deserves the phrase Vichakshana, but not Dhritarashtra, but still he was intelligent. Okay. Vichakshana, that means, oh, intelligent one. Vedaha, Vedavidam, Tratum, Nachet, Shaktaha. If Vedas are Tratum nache chaktaha, if they are incapable of protecting the person who is Vedavit, means who has learned the Vedas. So that he doesn't care for. What is that? Whether he does papa or that doing papa, he doesn't bother. So yes, after all, he has studied Vedas. If Vedas are incapable of protecting him, saving from the sins that he has incurred, he says, then God says, Vedaha, if the Vedas, Veda Vidam, and that way the one person who has that is learned the Vedas, so Tratum na Shaktan, Tratum na Chet Shaktaha, if they are incapable of protecting him, Atha, then Kasmat Brahmanaha, Brahmananam Ayam, Sanatanaha Pralapaha. Why this pralapa? Pralapa means prattling. Why this prattling of this Brahmana? Since when? Sanatanaha means Prachina Kala. From ancient time these Brahmanas are prattling these Vedas. What for? If they are incapable of saving him from the sin, why do they, means for no reason they are blabbing these Vedas which can't help them at all. So therefore, so kasmat, for what reason this Brahmana, of this Brahmana, so ayam sanatanaha pralapaha, not right now taken. Sanatana means what? From ancient time, from the kalpa, beginning of kalpa onward, this Vedic chanting and Vedic learning is going on. If it is incapable of protecting them, why should they take to this all this prattling? That is the question.
Nacet Veda Veda Vidam Dātum Shakta Vichakshana Atha Kasmatralapoyam Brahmananam Sanatanaha. So the doubt posed by Dhritarashtra is, if Vedas are not able to save the person who commits sin, so of what use are they? Now, this stand taken by Dhritarashtra can be true, provided Vedas are meant for protecting those persons who commit sins and chant the Vedas. Then it is okay. Then you can say Vedas don't protect the person, but the purpose of Vedas is not that. And the very fact that this person learns Vedas and doesn't adhere to its injunctions, because Vedas themselves prohibit from adharmic acts, sinful acts, and it does means, has he got Shraddha in Vedas? Certainly not. So that means though he may learn Vedas for some other purpose, he is not abiding by what is told in the Vedas. It is just like, see, a master has got two servants. One servant is the one always praises the master, but never obeys. Okay. The other servant is, he is nowhere near to praise the master, but always obeys and does what the master has told. Who is better? Who is dear to the master? Second, certainly. So therefore, like this person recites Vedas, but what is told by Vedas, he never adheres. So it is not meant for that at all. So therefore, you can't say that Vedas don't protect. Vedas certainly protect. Which type of person? The one who adheres what is told, that means adheres to all those what is told there, and thereby finally gains the knowledge of oneself. The karma kanda, upasana kanda portions are really not meant for gaining this and that. They are meant for antakarana shuddhi and chitta naishalya, so that finally one can gain the knowledge of oneself and get freed from samsara. This is the purpose of Vedas, nothing short of that. But in between, some results are certainly true, like swarga, etc., are possible by karma and upasana. But tatparya of Vedas, the main intention of Vedas is not in sending you to heavens, etc. It is in making you discover your own swarupa, which is free from samsara. So therefore, so Dhritarashtra's doubt is not correct. That is now being, take bhashya there. Bhavedayam pralapaha yadi eshaha eva vedarthaha asya. Means, Vedas which do not protect the person who commits sin, see, That means, then, therefore it is a pralapa, it's just a prattling, that is what Dhritarashtra accused. Yes. That means, Vedas can be prattling if, that is, eshaha eva vedarthasya. If this alone is the meaning or the purpose of Vedas, what is that? To protect the person who chants the Vedas at the same time commits the sins. If that is the purpose, but it is not so. Why? Anyaha eva swargadehe paramapurushartha mokshakhyaha vedartha. Artha here is prayojanam, not meaning. Okay, vedartha is prayojanam. That is, if that was the prayojana, either to gain heavens, etc., or to get freed from sin in spite of chanting Vedas and committing sins, if that were the case, yes, it will become pralapa. But the real purpose of Vedas or the is entirely different. What is that? Swargadehe anyaha eva paramapurushartha mokshakhyaha vedartha. The vedartha, the prayojana, artha here is prayojanam. The purpose of the utility or usefulness of Veda is something other than swargadehe. Swargadehe anyaha eva. Swarga adi for as he has thought that sins will be washed off, etc. So that is parama purushartha, highest purushartha, namely mokshakya, which is called as moksha. Then what about the karma? That means so much of karma and upasana told in the Vedas. What is the purpose? He says, itarasya cha karma rashehe upasanayascha. All the host of karmas from Agnihotra to Ashwamedha, A to Z karmas come in between there. So, is karma rashehe and also upasanayascha. And upasana, that means innumerable upasana that are told in the Vedas, they are meant for this purpose. What is that? Tat prapti sadhana jnana sadhana antakkarana shuddhi sadhana tvena paramparyena purushartatvadeva veda pratipadyatvam. Why are they discussed in the Vedas? Why are they told in the Vedas? They are told because, see, tat prapti sadhana jnana sadhana antakkarana shuddhi sadhana tvena. Moksha sadhana is what? Atma jnana, Brahma jnana. And sadhana for Atma jnana, Brahma jnana is karmas and upasana, so that he can gain antakarana shuddhi and chitta naishchalya. So therefore, tat prapti, tat stands for moksha. Moksha prapti sadhana, which is jnana sadhana, and its sadhana is antakarana shuddhi, and antakarana shuddhi sadhana is karma. So like this, one by one. So sadhana trina, paramparena, in succession means indirectly. Directly karma and upasanas will not give you moksha, but they certainly help you to get that ready frame of mind by which you can inquire and gain the knowledge by which you are bound to get freed from bondage. So sadhana trina, paramparena means indirectly, purushartatvadeva, because karma and upasana serve as the means of highest purushartha indirectly. So therefore, Veda pratipadyatvam. Therefore they are told there in the Vedas. But Vedas, find the base, Vedas are meant for gaining moksha only, nothing short of it. So this being the case, take the last para of the bhashya before the stanza start. Yasmadevam moksha tat sadhana pratipadakatvena samsaranartha nivritti hetutvam vedana. This is the purpose of Vedas. What is that? Moksha tat sadhana pratipadakatvena. So Vedas are moksha pratipadakas and tat sadhana means moksha sadhana pratipadakas. Vedas unfold what moksha is and give you what are the means to gain that moksha in terms of atma jnana. So, pratipadakatvena, and thereby what do they do? Samsaranartha nivritti hetutvam vedana. That is, Vedas serve as a means by which one can get totally freed from samsara. That is the purpose of them. Therefore, tasmad vedaha vedavidam tratum shaktaha eva. Therefore, Vedas are certainly capable of protecting, saving the one who is Vedavit, one who has studied and understood what Veda is and accordingly one has conducted oneself in life, certainly they protect, and not as you, Dhritarashtra, have understood, where the person commits sin at the same time learns Vedas, that is not going to help at all. So, vitratum shaktaha eva iti etat sarvam abhipretyaha. Keeping this in mind, now three stanzas are further given. First, that is, what is that paramapurushartha? That is, tatra pratamena means by first stanza means seventh stanza. Nitya paroksham paramapurushartham paramatmanam darshayati. The highest gain of life is to discover the paramatma. And where is that paramatma? That paramatma is aparoksha. What is meant by aparoksha? That paramatma, where is that paramatma? Say aparoksham, he said. Nitya, not aparoksham, but nitya aparoksham.
No pariksha, not perception.
Means what does it mean? You see, paroksha means remote. Pratyaksha means directly perceptible. Aparoksha is na paroksham. That which is not paroksha, equally it is not pratyaksha. That which is neither remote nor directly perceptible through the jnanendriya, what is that? I. Only one thing. I alone is neither remote, because are you away from yourself? No. But is that I pratyaksha directly available for cognition? Can you see I?
No.
Not these eyes. I means how to aham, my, me, who? I hope so. Who? So okay. Others will say, what is who? Gujarati, who? Okay, like this. Neno. Neno. All these. So, how is it? That means that me, that I, that real I, is not perceptible through sense organs. So therefore, that which is neither paroksha nor pratyaksha, therefore called as aparoksha, can be aham, me and me alone, that is what I, it can be. So therefore, nitya paroksham, paramatma is nitya paroksham, means what? Paramatma is verily I. Do you know presently? I think Vedanta speaks funny things, is it not? Huh? What is this? See, it says that I am paramatma, however is possible. That means you have mistaken yourself to be what you are not, that's all. Presently what you take to be I is wrong, that's all. So therefore inquire and discover that you are verily paramatma. That Chaitanya Tattva itself is paramatma tattva. So therefore that is the paramapurushartha, that is the tatparya, the main intention of Shruti, and therefore certainly the Vedas do protect the person who is Vedavit from that word, from what? Not just papa punya, from entire bondage and from samsara. That is now to answer now. Sanat Sujata Uvacha. Tasyaiva namadi vishesha rupaihi. Idam jagad bhati mahanubhava. Visha samyak pravadanti vedaha. Tadvishva vairupya mudaharanti. Mahanubhava. Tasya ad paramatmanaha namadi vishesha rupaihi idam jagat bhati ad iti nirdishya. There you can add there before nirdishya. Maya nirmitam bahurupam nirdishya. Or jagat swarupam nirdishya. Or karyam nirdishya. So one adhyara can be maya nirmitam bahurupam nirdishya. Or jagat swarupam nirdishya. Or karyam nirdishya. Karyam nirdishya. Eva, first line, tasya eva is that. nirdesha eva sammyak. Again add rupam. Sammyak add rupam. Vedaha tad pravadanti. No, vedaha pravadanti. Vedaha pravadanti. Then add munayaha api. Munayaha api tad vishva vairupyam. Add idi udaharanti. Tad vishva vairupyam iti udaharanti. Mahanubhava, O great person. This king is, therefore, O great person, O king. Tasya paramatmanaha. What do the Vedas do? See, first they point out that this entire jagat is nothing but projection of this paramatma only. Is something superimposed on paramatma only. This jagat of nama rupa has no existence existence apart from paramatma only. That is first they point out. And thereafterwards, what is the swarupa of paramatma? That is what is told in the Veda. So that is it. Tasya eva. What is tasya? Tasya paramatmanaha. Tasya paramatmanaha. Namadi vishesha rupaihi idam jagat bhati iti nirdishya. Having shown how of that same paramatma, namadi vishesha rupaihi, in the form of nama adi, nama, rupa, all these, so in form, in terms of all these, vishesha. Vishesha means those which have got characteristic features, gunas, which are drishyas. So vishesha rupaihi, idam jagat bhati, this entire jagat shines, means appears to be there, iti. Maya nirmitam bahurupam nirdishya. Having shown the bahurupa, that means the paramatma appearing as though of many forms. How can paramatma become many? Because it is kutastha, ananda, satyam. How it can be many? Maya nirmitam. Maya nirmitam. How do you say so? Because shruti is there. That is, Vedas say, Indra maya bhi pururupaha iyate. Indra means paramatma. Maya bhi, by maya, pururupaha. Pururupaha means bahurupaha. He appears as though having many forms. Iti so, maya nirmitam bahurupam nirdishya. Having shown that. Thereafter, what do they do? Tasya eva, of that very nirdishya, tasya eva, of that very paramatma. Which paramatma? The paramatma who has become, that means, as though bahurupa, because of maya, of that very same maya, paramatma, sammyak rupam, the real nature, where it is said, same Brahmanika, tadetad brahma purvam, anaparam, anantaram, abhayam, ayamātmā brahma sarvānubhūti iti anuśāsanam iti pravadanti vedāha. So there, first having shown due to māyā, paramātmā appears to be having all these forms of entire creation. Thereafter what is said there? The samyak rūpam, the real nature of paramātmā as brahma apūrvam means which is not, which has no cause, anaparam which has no effect means the bahurupa is false in nature. See, Brahma, jagat is projected on Brahma, but you can't say that jagat is karya of Brahma really. It is not parinama. If at all you have to say karya, it is what karya it is? Vivarta. Vivarta karya, okay. But actually it is not actual karya because paramatma has not undergone any change. Just as you can't say delicious snake as the real effect of rope, because rope has never become the snake. It is not parinama at all. It is not a modification of the rope to become a snake. So therefore, see, that way, so it has no effect from, real effect from it, nor has it got any cause. So anantaram abhayam, neither inside nor outside is there. Ayam atma, this atma, brahma, sarvanubhuti bhuhu. Sarvanubhuti means the very anubhava swarupa of one and all. So that means it doesn't need any other pramana to that means the experience. So anubhava swarupa iti anushasanam, this is the declaration of the Veda. So therefore, first having shown that the nama rupatmaka jagat is nothing but this Paramatma, afterwards the what is the swarupa of Paramatma is described. Or you can take that nirvishya like this, means taking different quotations from the Shruti. Devava brahmanaha rupe murtam cha murtam cha ityadina. So first brahma rupa, means the nature of brahma is two types. What is that? Murta, amurta. Murta means with form, saguna. Amurta is nirguna without the form. So it means the jagat has no existence apart from the brahma paramatma. Thereafter the real nature is what? Neti neti ityadina tasya sammag rupam pravadanti vedaha. First nirdesha, how Paramatma has got two rupa. One is murta and amurta, means one with the form, one other with the other without the form. First to account the jagat, in the sense jagat has no existence apart from Brahma. But that is not the jagat, is not the real nature of Brahma. Therefore afterward Brahadaranyaka, what does it do? Neti neti, naiti, naiti, whatever that is available in terms of murta, form, that is not actually real nature of Brahma. So first adhyaropa is shown, afterwards apavada, negation. So therefore, iti vedaha pravadanti. So that is how, that is Vedas, this unfold or describe what Brahma is. So that again, also, other way also, that is namadi vishesha rupaihi idam jagat bhati iti nirdesha. How? In terms of, in Taittiriya, tasmadva etvasmad atmana akasha sambhutaha akashad vayu, etc. Entire creation is from whom? Brahma. Afterwards, panchakosha viveka is done, samyak rupa is shown. Brahma puchyam pratishtha. So that is the very basis is what? Brahma. All koshas are negated as anatma. So like that, samyak rupa is shown. Or it can be chandogya, it can be taken. Narada goes to Sanat Kumara. Which Sanat Kumara? Same Sanat Sujata, both are one. So, adhi bhagavaha itiha upasasada. This highly learned Narada, one is past master in 64 vidyas, when goes and says, soham bhagava shochami, shokasya param matarayatu, O Bhagavan, I am in grief, therefore please help me to get cross over this sorrow. He asks, what all you learned? He gives a long list. And afterward he says, okay, we have learned everything other than what is to be learned. So that's what he says. Now then he teaches. But before teaching, he shows all the, that how the jagat is nothing but this manifestation, I mean a projection of this Brahma, Bhuma, that is called Bhuma. And then he says, this is not the real nature. Bhuma, limitless and limitlessness alone is the real nature. We say there, first what is teaches him? Namadi pranantam tasyaiva maya nimittam jagan nirdishya. Then Sanat Kumar gives a long list of so many things, aspects of creation. Beginning from nama means name, ending with the prana. Pranantam, pranantam, tasya eva, all this is bhashya. Tasya eva maya nimittam jagan nirdishya. That means this is on account of maya, it appears as jagat because of, that is superimposed on Brahma, having shown thereafterward the samyak rupa, the real nature of Brahma, is shown how yatra nanyat pashyati, nanyat srinoti, nanyat vijanati sa bhuma. There, wherein nothing else is seen, nothing else is heard, nothing else is felt, that is what Bhuma means, limitless, that is the swarupa of Brahma, means entire jagat is falsely superimposed on Brahma. Like this, in different, at various places, first what the Shruti shows, that the jagat has no existence apart from Brahma. Finally, the superimposed jagat is negated, that I am shown that what is the swarupa as totally free from jagat. That is, prapanch is here, where Mundakovasha, Mandukya, prapanchopa shamam. So therefore, like this, it shows pravadanti vedaha, samyak rupam pravadanti vedaha. Now, not only Vedas the declare or unfold that. Even the great masters, the great rishis also have shown that way also. Therefore, he says, munayaha, yes, vedaha, munaya pravadanti, munayaha api. The munayaha, that means great munis also who have written smritis. So therefore, they also, what do they say? They tad. What is that tad? Tad Brahma. Tad means tad Brahma. What is the nature of Brahma? The Brahma is like this. What is the nature of Brahma? The Brahma is Vishwavairupyam. What is Vishwavairupyam? It is distinct from Vishwa, the Jagat. Your Vishwa is not Vishwa Pradnya Tayasa, not that way. Vishwa means entire Jagat. So therefore, Vishwavairupyam means Vishwa Rupa Viparita Swarupam. Bhashya. So that whose Swarupa is ulta to Vishwa. You first define Vishwa. Adi or Anadi? Sadi or Anadi?
Sadi.
Brahma is? Anadi. Vishwa is Santa or Ananta? Brahma is Ananta. Vishwa is, Parinami or Putastha? Parinami. Brahma is Putastha. Vishwa, Dukkha is there or not? Nothing but Dukkha. Brahma is? Nothing but? Ananda. Dukkha means Ananda Sarupa, isn't it? Anything. So, Vishwa is Vitatha or Avitatha? Okay. Vishwa is Satya or Asatya? Satya? Asatya means Mithya. Brahma is? Satya means Vishwa is Vitatham and Brahma is Avitatham. So, anything you talk about creation, Jagat, Brahma is right ulta to that. So, therefore, he says, so Vishwa Viparita Swarupam, Vishwa Rupa Viparita Swarupam, the one that is Brahma, they describe Brahma as the one which is totally opposed to the nature of Jagat Vishwa Udaharanti. That is what they show. Therefore, don't be under impression that Vedas cannot protect the Vedavid, but you should know.